वेलकम स्टूडेंट्स इन द डिस्कशन ऑफ एमसीक्यूज ऑन चैप्टर मैग्नेटिज्म। वी नो दैट मैग्नेटिक फील्ड इज रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय द मैग्नेटिक लाइंस ऑफ फोर्स नोन एज मैग्नेटिक फ्लक्स। लाइंस ऑफ फोर्स स्टार्ट फ्रॉम नॉर्थ पोल एंड एंड ऑन द साउथ पोल। मैग्नेटिक डायपोल मोमेंट ऑफ मैग्नेट इज गिवन बाय कैपिटल एम इज इक्वल टू स्मॉल एम इंटू कैपिटल एल, वेयर स्मॉल एम इज द मैग्नेटिक पोल स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ ए मैग्नेट। इन दिस लेक्चर विल सॉल्व द इम्पॉर्टेंट एम सी क्यूज आस्क इन द नीट एंड जेई एग्जाम। एज शोन इन द फिगर वी कैन सी when a wire of length L is bent into different shapes, length of it change and we get the value of magnetic field and magnetic dipole moment is equal to M upon root 2 for 90 degree angle bending, M upon 3 for wire bent into three parts of equal length. Magnetic dipole moment change when we bent it into different shapes. For bending wire at 90 degree angle into three parts will give magnetic dipole moment M upon 3. For semicircular bending, magnetic dipole moment becomes twice M upon pi. M is the original value for the straight wire of length L. And for the circular loop, here we can calculate magnetic dipole moment. In the MCQ type of questions, any shape will be asked, we have to find out the answer. Let us discuss in detail. Let us take first example, a straight magnetized wire of magnetic moment M is bent into shape as shown in the figure. It is bent into the five parts of equal length. L is bent into five parts, so length of one part will be L upon 5. Find the final magnetic moment. To find the magnetic moment, we can find out the resultant length between the points, suppose end points A and B. Using the Pythagoras theorem, AB is equal to square root of BC square plus AC square. But here BC is L upon 5 and AC is twice L upon 5 from calculations. And hence AB is equal to square of BC square and AC square. L square upon 25 plus 4 L square upon 25 is equal to L upon root 5. So here AB is equal to L upon root 5. Magnetic moment of any dipole is directly proportional to straight distance between the poles, and hence magnetic moment is given by M into L upon L into root 5, that is M upon root 5. An iron rod of length L and magnetic moment L is bent to form a semicircle. Now its magnetic moment will be. Options are given capital M, option B twice M upon pi, option C M upon pi, and option D M pi. In the end, I will give you the short trick to solve this all type of bending. Without calculation, you can calculate the values. First, let us learn step by step how the answer has come. Now here, the wire of length L is bent into a semicircle. So this length is equal to half the circumference. That is 2 pi r upon 2 is pi r. L is equal to pi r. From the wire of length L, this semicircle of length pi r is formed. So radius is equal to L upon pi. And we know that magnetic dipole moment is equal to ML, and capital M is equal to M into length is now here. This length is R plus R, that is twice R, and R is equal to L upon pi. And substituting this value, we get value as here twice M upon pi. We can find out this by one short form is equal to M sin theta upon 2 upon theta upon 2. This wire is bent into a semicircle, so theta will take as pi. So sin pi by 2 is 1. And hence we get 2 times sin pi by 2 upon pi, that is twice m upon pi answer directly. This is a short trick on this topic. Next, a steel wire of length L has a magnetic moment M is bent into a circular arc. The new magnetic moment is, it is repetition of last question. Let us repeat this question. Options are given m upon pi, twice m upon pi, 3m upon pi, and 4m upon pi. Okay. Now here, wire is bent into a semicircle. Let m be its pole strength. Then m is equal to capital M is equal to small m, ml, and distance between the poles is twice L upon pi, calculated from length is equal to half circumference, R is equal to L upon pi, and hence distance between the poles R plus R is 2 times L upon pi, and hence M is equal to M into twice L upon pi. Substitute this value here, and hence we get answer twice M upon pi. Next MCQ is here, a wire is bent into an arc, and here angle of bending is 60 degrees. What will be magnetic dipole moment? Here length of arc is equal to radius into angle pi by 3, so pi r upon 3. Angle is equal to arc upon the radius. So this value L is equal to pi r upon 3. And hence radius is equal to 3L upon pi. Magnetic dipole moment M is equal to M into L. That is here twice r sine 30 degrees. Its value is equal to 3M upon pi. Using the short trick also, we can solve this M into sine of 60 upon 2, theta upon 2, that is 60 upon 2 is 30, sine 30 is half. So M into half upon M into sine 60 upon half divided by 60 degree means pi by 3 is equal to 3M upon pi. A straight wire current I is turned into a circular loop if the magnitude of magnetic moment associated with the MKS unit is capital M, the length of the wire will be. Here length of that wire is asked, which is turned into a circular loop. Magnetic dipole moment of a current carrying wire is equal to IA. Here A is the area of this circular loop, area of a circle is pi r square. So we get here m is equal to I into pi r square. Since a circular loop is formed, length is equal to 2 pi r. R is equal to L upon twice y. Substituting this value in the equation, m is equal to I into pi into L upon 2 pi bracket square. L square is equal to 4 pi m upon I. L is equal to square root of 4 pi m divided by I. Yes. Next, in the next topic, on this chapter magnetism, combination of magnets with their position are given and we have to find the resultant magnetic dipole moment. Now in the figure, two magnets are in the perpendicular direction with south-south near each other, north-south-south-north anti-parallel combination. And here at this angle and in the fourth at this angle. Then how we will find magnetic dipole moment? For the first combination, since here magnetic field lines, magnetic dipole moment from south, it has direction from south to north. Angle between them is 90 degrees, and suppose magnetic dipole moment is same mm, then using the formula capital M net is equal to square root of m1 square plus m2 square plus twice m1 m2 cos of theta, we get a value as square root of m square plus twice m into m cos of 90 degrees. Since cos 90 is 0, we get square root of m square plus m square is equal to 2 times square root of m. In the second diagram, two magnetic dipole moments are anti-parallel to each other. So theta is pi, cos of pi is minus 1, and hence answer is square root of m minus m, that is 0. In third combination, the angle given is 30 degrees. Angle between the two dipole moments is 30 degrees, and hence cos of here 30 since is square root of 3/2. Substituting the values, net dipole moment for such combination is square root of 3 here m square plus m square plus 2 into m square. Square root of 3/2 is equal to m square root of 2 plus root 3. In the last fourth combination, angle given is 60 degree in the question, and cos 60 is half, and hence we get value m into square root of root 3. So on four combinations, four MCQs can be asked. Yes, here about the last MCQs, theory is given here. Different combinations of magnets at different angles are given. So magnetic dipole moment, since it is a vector quantity, will make different angles. And we get M net is equal to square root of M1 square plus M2 square plus twice M1 M2 cos of theta. And angle tan alpha of the resultant vector with any one of the magnetic dipole moment is equal to m2 sin theta upon m1 plus m2 cos of theta. Thank you.